Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to determine the position of a particle moving on a circular path using the angular abscissa. Determine the angular velocity. Determine the angular acceleration. And solve an exercise about a particle moving on a circular path.
In this animation, a particle moves on a circular path. In circular motion, the trajectory is a circle of radius r. Consider a particle moving on a circular path. In previous episodes, we determined the position of the particle using the position vector, which starts at the origin O of coordinates. Also, we use the arc length S to determine the position of the particle. Now, we want to determine the position of the particle using the angular abscissa. The angular abscissa is denoted by theta. In this position, we take theta equals 0. Now, what is the relation between S, theta, and the radius r of the circle? Theta equals S over r. Theta is expressed in radians in SI units. S and r have the same unit. Now, if the particle covers a complete circular path, then the arc length would be equal to 2 pi r, which is the circumference of the circle. Replace S in this expression by 2 pi r. The r's cancel out. Therefore, theta becomes 2 pi radians, which means that when the particle describes one complete circle, then its arc length is 2 pi r and it describes an angle of 2 pi radians.
We proved that in the previous slide, theta equals s over r, which has the form of k times s, where k equals 1 over r, which is a constant. So let's differentiate both sides with respect to time. The derivative of theta with respect to time is theta prime. The derivative of ks with respect to time is k times s prime, but k equals 1 over r. So the derivative of ks equals 1 over r times s prime, but s prime equals v. So theta prime equals v over r. Theta prime is the angular velocity, is the time rate of change of the angular abscissa. In SI units, theta prime is expressed in radians per second and V is expressed in meters per second. Now, using this formula, theta prime equals V over R, which has the form of K times V. Now, let's differentiate this relation with respect to time. The derivative of theta prime with respect to time is theta w prime, and the derivative of vr, v over r, with respect to time is v prime over r. But v prime is the tangential acceleration, so theta w prime equals the tangential acceleration over the radius of the circle. Theta w prime is called the angular acceleration, which is the time rate of change of the angular velocity. In SI units, theta w prime is expressed in radians per second squared and AT is expressed in meters per second squared.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's solve an application. A particle P moves along a circular path of radius 2 meters. Its angular abscissa is given by this expression, 4t squared plus 2t plus pi over 2 in SI units, which means that t is expressed in seconds and theta in radians. Number one, write the expressions of the angular velocity and the angular acceleration of P. The angular velocity is the time derivative of the angular abscissa. So let's differentiate this expression with respect to time. The derivative of 4t squared with respect to time is 8t. The derivative of 2t is 2. And the derivative of pi over 2 is 0. Then theta prime equals 8t plus 2 in SI units. Now, let's move to the angular acceleration, which is the time derivative of the angular velocity. The derivative of at with respect to time is 8, and the derivative of 2 is 0. Therefore, theta w prime equals 8 radians per second squared. Number 2, deduce the expression of the value of the velocity and specify whether p is moving in the positive sense. To find the expression of the value of the velocity, we will use this relation, v equals r theta prime. R equals 2 meters, theta prime equals 8t plus 2, then v equals 16t plus 4 in SI units. Now, to specify whether p is moving in the positive sense, we can use the expression of theta prime or the expression of v. In the expression of v, t is positive, then v is positive at any instant. Therefore, p is moving in the positive sense. If we want to use the expression of theta prime, we say that t is positive and then theta prime is positive, and therefore the particle is moving in the positive sense.
Number 3. Calculate the value of the tangential acceleration of p. We know that the tangential acceleration is given by this relation, at equal r times theta w prime. But theta w prime equals 8 radians per second squared, proved in the previous slide, and r equals 2 meters. So, at equals 2 times 8 equals 16 meters per second squared. Number 4. Calculate the angular abscissa and the angular velocity at time equal to seconds. The angular abscissa is given by 4t squared plus 2t plus pi over 2. So, theta of 2, replace t by 2 seconds in the expression of theta, so theta of 2 equals 4 times 2 squared plus 2 times 2 plus pi over 2, which is equal to 21.57 radians. Similarly, theta prime of 2, replace t by 2 seconds in the expression of theta prime, so theta prime of 2 equals 8 times 2 plus 2, which is equal to 18 radians per second.
Let's move to part 5. Determine the number of rotations performed by p during the time interval 0 to 2 seconds. First, let's determine the angular abscissa at time 0 and at time 2 seconds. Replace t by 0 in the expression of theta. This is going to be theta 0 equals pi over 2 radians. Again, replace t by 2 in the expression of theta. Therefore, theta at time 2 seconds equals 21.57 radians. Now, let's calculate the variation in theta. Delta theta equals theta at time 2 minus theta at time 0. Delta theta is the angular displacement. Then replace theta at time 2 seconds by 21.57 and at time 0 by pi over 2 radians. Therefore, delta theta equals 20 radians. Now, to calculate the number of rotations, we just divide the angular displacement, or the absolute value of the angular displacement, by 2 pi, because each complete circular path represents 2 pi radians. Now, replace delta theta by 20 and pi by 3.14, therefore, n equals 3.18 rotations.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.